If tradition say yes, then I say no. If tradition say yes, then I say no. My dear brothers and sisters, as usual, I am Mabel Ruth Bayo from Guinea-Conakry, West Africa. Did God ever speak to any prophet about this secret society of female genital mutilation? No. Which prophet or prophets that God have direct communication with him about female genital mutilation? This is my question. Is there anybody to answer me? Is there any answer towards this question? Which part of the Bible or the Quran is it written that we, the women, should go through this evil practice? We should stand up and condemn this practice of FGM that is surrounding us. And I comprehensively have the right to condemn it. And you have the right to condemn it. It should be immediately alacrity. Since the beginning, FGM is a significant milestone, as we all are aware that the practice of FGM is prohibited in the world today. But the law against it is not applicable in the world, and more especially in Africa. You people who practice female genital mutilation, why won't you just sit down and think? Did God speak to any prophet about those female genital mutilation? Or which prophet did God have direct communication with? Let me just give you a cogent reasons why this satanic practice should not be encouraged in our midst. Here are my cogent reasons. One, every child has the right to live healthy and to have a healthy body. Oh yes, every child has the right. We have the right. We have the right to live healthy. God created us for us to be happy, not for us to feel pain and sorrows. Why are you taking off their clitoris? Why? Why? It is not an obligation, my dear people. It is not an obligation for you people to practice female genital mutilation. Female genital mutilation, it is a complete movement of Satan. I am not caught. I am always happy. And I am proud of not being initiated. Female genital mutilation, FGM, reduces the sexual desire of women. Victims of FGM knows what I am talking about. Victims of FGM are sexually castrated and sexually disgruntled. It is very difficult for women who have been caught to live in a society that condemns this tradition. Oh yes, it is difficult for them. It is difficult for them to live in a society where the sick people are campaigning to stop this evil practice. Some of them are not even happy. Please, let's put our hands together to stop female genital mutilation. It is time for us to say no to this tradition. It is time for us to fight for our rights. It is time for us to know the truth of this evil, evil, evil practice. The truth of this evil practice is that it's not good. It is not good. We need to stop it. We really need to stop it. Condemn female genital mutilation. Condemn female genital mutilation. Please, may God help us. Take a good look at me. I am not initiated. Take a good look at me. I am beautiful. I'm looking nice. And I know my rights. So I want you guys to know your rights as well. When you're not initiated, you feel so happy and you have a long, long life. You feel so healthy.